Leah, and today I want to share with you how I make my green salsa. It's very easy, very simple, and it's very delicious. And the special thing about this salsa is that you can use it with just about everything. You can make green enchiladas, green chilaquiles, if you want to make eggs, scrambled eggs, sunny side up, huevos rancheros, you can put it on top, even a burrito, or if you come home late and you just want to make a quesadilla and you want to use the salsa, it's just great. My husband grew up with having green salsa in the fridge, and it's just lovely again to come home late from work and be able to make the quesadilla and use it. So let's go over the ingredients. Again, it's very simple. I strongly recommend you go and buy all these at a Mexican store because you for sure will find the peppers and the tomatillos. So first, this is the peppers that you need. They are called chile serrano, and they are about, I don't know, 4 or 5 inches long, very spicy. Then you need the tomatillos, green tomatoes. This is how they look. You have to peel them, wash them, then they look like this, and then you'll cut them. You need a little bit of olive oil, some garlic, cilantro and onion. And I don't know why, but I was raised with cooking everything with chicken broth powder, so I also put some of that. And some salt, and you're set. So the first thing you need to do is wash the cilantro, the peppers, and the tomatoes. Once you have that done, you can remove these from the peppers. This is a tomatillo, you have to peel it. Once you peel it, again, you wash it, then they look like this. And I like cutting them in fours. It's much easier to cook. So now let's start making the salsa. You need a pan, and on the pan you put about 5 to 6 tablespoons of olive oil. And then you put the peppers with the garlic only for a while. So let's go and start making our salsa. Okay, so now we're gonna start actually making the salsa. You put the olive oil on the pan. It doesn't need to be too high or too low, just put it on medium. Then you can put the garlic. Then you add the peppers. I use about 10 peppers, but I would start with 3 to 5 if I were you. It could be very spicy. Then you can continue adding when your tooth becomes more spicy tolerant. I recommend you to cover this, but not completely. You need to let some air out to breathe. If you cover it, they will be broiling and you want them to be almost burned. So we're gonna give it about 10 to 15 minutes and then we'll come back and add the tomatoes. Okay, so 10 minutes later, this is what you should be looking at. The peppers are almost burned, as well as the garlic, look at that. Very burned. In Mexico we call it chile soreado. Once you have this, you add your 10 tomatillos. Very important, you add about a cup of water. You add about a teaspoon of salt and the chicken broth powder. And then you cover it until the tomatoes are fully cooked for about 20 minutes now. So we'll be back to see the final product. Thank you. Okay, now we're gonna check on the salsa and see how it's going. As you can see, it's broiling. We're gonna give it a little more time. What you're looking at, what you need to see, something like this, that's almost fully cooked. As you can see, there's still some not cooked tomatoes. So let's give it a little more time. And we'll come back. Okay, so now it's been about 20 minutes. You can turn that off now. And this is what you need to look at. You need to find your salsa like this, completely cooked. Now we're going to put it in this container to basically smash it.
careful not getting burned. So you have it like this. And go back. I'm gonna smash it. Until everything is completely smashed. Again, just to recap, you need about 10 tomatillos, 3 to 5 to 10 chiles serranos, garlic, about 1 teaspoon of salt, 5 of olive oil, a little bit of chicken broth powder. You put it all in the pan. Now it's ready to be served. So now, this is optional. I like doing it when I serve it. You put a little bit of onion, little squares. You combine it with a little bit of cilantro. This is more like an ornament, but it definitely does give some flavor to your salsa. So once your guests arrive and you're ready to serve it, you can put it in a bowl. You can put some of this on top. And if you even want to look fancier than this, you can even cut some avocado in squares and add it so your guests can enjoy some green salsa with cilantro, onion, and a little bit of avocado. So I hope you enjoy it with your friends and family, and it's been a pleasure having you watch my video. Take care. Bye-bye. Adios.